another shot. Drinkity Drinks, I wanted to show you a store haul that I did for 2022. So I'm gonna go over all the bottles that I ended up finding so far this year. It actually was just in like a couple stores. So before I do that, I wanted to show you some of these bitters that I got. They're called Strong Water. I don't know if any of you guys ever heard of these bitters. There's cherry, aromatic, walnut, orange, and lavender. So I guess it'll be pretty good in a cocktail. I did try the walnut one already, which was really good in this banana sort of old fashioned that I made. And I also have Fog Hat wood chips or whatever it's called, maple, hickory, sweet Texas mesquite, and whiskey barrel oak. I don't know if you guys had any of these. If you did, you could let me know which one is like really good. I think the one that smelled good was the sweet, no, the whiskey barrel oak, and maybe the hickory. I'm not sure. I have to smell them again. I'm waiting to get this smoker in so I could try them, and then I'll let you guys know which one's really good. So let's get into the bottles that I ended up picking up. I'll start off with this tequila, San Matias Gran Reserva. It's extra añejo. I don't know if you guys ever tried this, but it's supposed to be a really, really good tequila, especially for the money. It's under 50 bucks, so I want to put it up against the El Tesoro one day and see how well it does, but this is supposed to give it a run for its money, and it's extra añejo. So like I said, I heard a lot of good things about it. This Sazerac rye is not sold here or around here in Florida, but they did start bringing it. Apparently it's in like Sam's Clubs now. So I ended up finding this at Sam's Club for like pretty cheap, but I've only seen this in Chicago, but I didn't have a carry on, so I was unable to bring it back. But I did want this, but I just could not find it. I'm sure you guys heard of this Buffalo Trace Sazerac rye, but I want to try it in an actual Sazerac cocktail and see if it's the best, or even by itself, if it's worth the I think it was like 25 bucks. The other thing I found was this. It's a liter of Buffalo Trace, a single barrel store pick. So I don't know if there's differences. Have you guys noticed a difference? Have you guys had a single barrel Buffalo Trace pick? I don't know if there's if it's really that good. I do have regular Buffalo Trace, which is good. I want to know if there is a difference. I am going to try them before I finish this. I want to pour some in two different glasses and try to taste and compare them. Hopefully this is better, but I had gotten a decent deal on it. I think I only paid 30 bucks, and like I said, it's a whole liter and it's a store pick. So, but I didn't know that there was differences. I have no idea. There probably isn't. I ended up picking up this. Some of you guys might know what this is, especially if you know, if you make drinks. It's called chartreuse. Yeah, this is used in a lot of cocktails, like The Last Word. Some of you guys might have heard of that if you're like a gin fan. They also have one that's a spinoff of it with bourbon, which I want to make with it, but a lot of other ones. But it's supposed to be a really good mixture and go, you know, goes well with into a bar. And I believe this stuff is, it's sort of like Angostura bitters or something like that. It's like a recipe since 1605, so it's been around for a while, but it's supposed to be amazing even by itself. I've never had it by itself, but I believe I've had it in a cocktail. This next one, and now we're getting into two of like my favorite bottles that I really, really wanted, but I didn't want to fork over the money for them. But I did see them at this place. Now the only reason I ended up getting this one, this right here, is the Peerless Double Oak. This is actually a store pick too, from the same place I bought this. The only way they were gonna sell me this one is if I bought one of their store picks. Then they sold me this for 30 bucks. Ended up getting this Peerless Double Oak store pick from the same place. I did wanna try this. I wanna compare it to the Woodford Double Oak, which is supposed to be similar, but this is supposed to be better. I guess some people say it's better. I have no idea, but it looks good. It's super freaking dark, and I love like almost double oaked anything. It's supposed to be really, really sweet. I think this is going to be wonderful. I can't wait to get into this bottle. I mean, I've yet to try Peerless, period. It'd be good to just, you know, try one of their products. Now, the last bottle that I got is like on the top of a lot of people's list for 2021, and I've tried it before at the place where I got most of these bottles. You can test out bourbons, and I tried it, and it's the one I was gonna get last time. You probably heard me mention it, but I ended up getting that Remus Repeal 5. But I did want this one, but I seen the Remus Repeal 5, which was even harder to get around here, and that was the one I had got for like New Year's. But now I ended up getting the bottle that I really wanted, and honestly, when I think it in my head, to me, it's better than Remus Repeal.
This
barrel seagrass. This thing has so much freaking flavor. It's like freaking fireworks in your mouth or something like that. It's just crazy, trippy flavors, fruits flavors. Like, I don't know if it's apricot peach or something like that. Like, there's really, really strong, bright drink. Like, it's just crazy bright. Like, this is the one I'm going to use to make that drink with the chartreuse. I think it's really going to open up and make it super bright. When I do a review, I'll end up using this and making it. So it's distilled in Kentucky from Indiana, Tennessee, and Canada. I think it's MGP, but it's 119 proof. And yeah, apricot brandy barrel. So I guess that's where you get the apricot flavor from. If you guys never tried this, try it. Get it. It's worth every penny that it costs. This is really good and really different. I've never tried anything close to something like this. Like, it's just a totally different, almost its own league as far as like bourbon or whiskeys or something. Yeah, I definitely recommend this, and I can't wait to crack this and do a video on that. I think it'd be really cool. So yeah, these are the bottles I ended up picking up. I'd like to know your thoughts. Have you tried a barrel pick of this one? What do you think about it? Can you notice the difference between this and regular Buffalo Trace? Have you tried Peerless? Is this better than the Woodford Double Oak? Because that's like one of the best, sweetest Double Oak bourbons. I put that right up there with 1910 or something like that. Have you tried San Matias? Is this like one of your top tequilas? I know for under 50 bucks, I think I got this for like 40. To get an extra añejo that cheap is like super crazy, but I could tell they saved with the bottle because it's a twist off top. It looks like a sticker on it. So the bottle ain't nothing to, you know, write home to mom about. Oh, it's a Sazerac company. Yeah, Sazerac just owns everything. It's crazy. I've not even known that it's aged for 3 years in high quality white oak barrels. Yeah, so this is from Sazerac, from freaking Buffalo Trace. Anyways, I've heard good things about it. Have you tried that? And have you tried Seagrass? What'd you think about it? Was it one of your top whiskeys of last year? It is the best rye I've ever tried, hands down. So yeah, there it is. Until next time, get yourself a drink. Drink something you love.